I have some friends that call it prostitutional surfing, not professional. That's pretty funny. It's pretty accurate. Yeah, probably. A little bit of truth in that. But I don't know, it's strange. I don't know how else to say it. To be able to have a roof over my head and food in my belly because of surfing is very strange. I've always thought it strange. Like, imagine if you were an alien looking at Earth, and you'd come down and you zoom in on the edge of the oceans where the ocean meets the land, and there's this group of people that, and some of them can wiggle and move their bodies on waves just a little bit faster or a little bit more technical than other people, and that difference is what enables some of them to have a beautiful house to live in, a lot of time on their hands, good food to eat, and some strange thing called fame. Out far enough and have a bigger point of view, and we all really are the same on this little blue orb, 3 stones from the sun. Right here is called Psychedelic Valley, and basically it's where everyone came to get their magic mushrooms and trip out and connect with the earth in the way people do when they take mushrooms. And so all the surfers and the crew from around here, all the hippies and the surfing crew in the 70s and whatnot, coined this little spot Psychedelic Valley. And so it was also a site where, you know, a lot of experimentation was happening with ways of living, ways of growing food, ways of relating to other people and other animals in this space, and also a lot of experimentation with surfing. Batty Treloa, all these sort of surfing crew from around here were deeply going down the rabbit hole of the surfing world. And so that was definitely one part of this area that really attracted me as a little kid, you know, wanting to come here where there's just amazing surf and really creative, open-minded people, you know, not ultra competitive and sporty and jockey, you know, more kind of like interested in how surfing could play a part in your life in ways that were wonderful, not just ways that made you a winner. So that was pretty exciting. Have you ever heard of wabi-sabi? The Japanese concept of wabi-sabi? If you look at those flowers here, these drying flowers in the vase, wabi-sabi is like the appreciation of not only like the young, the youthful, bright expression of things, like the flower opening, but also like appreciating the other end of the journey, like the drying, the withering, the decaying. And it's such an awesome concept because it's like appreciating the things that are a little rough or imperfect or yeah, like those flowers, and still appreciating and seeing something that makes your heart sing, and you feel good. It's a wabi-sabi, wabi sabi. Yeah, the beauty in the whole spectrum, you know, appreciating and enjoying that as well, not being fixed, like a lot of modern cultures fixed on. Like pop music and young celebrity, young period in life, all of these, you know, things like the beautiful new fresh flowers for gifts and things like that. But also just like looking at those, they're still really beautiful to me. It's cool. Yeah, the good thing, I think if you were a bear, that's a pretty cool analogy, you know, just having a time where you're out in the world and you're, you know, in the forests and in the world around you, and then there's times where, I guess, the bear is in the cave and resting and turning inward, and that's definitely something I enjoy doing. But that's something I reckon you gain from surfing. Surfing's such a teacher of that. Of being able to ride waves even when you're back on land, to understand and to feel and to move with all of the different wavelengths. For me, if I like take my focus out from just being a single human being that is separate from every other human being and separate from this world, if I forget that and have a bigger perspective of who I am, then that's when you get the experience of eternity or infinite or immortal or living forever, because my spirit or my awareness can go far beyond the body. You know, like all the coolest times in my life, like really amazing deep tube rides in surfing or great musical moments, or amazing sex, or even sometimes good food, or experiences with death and birth. I don't even feel my body, you know? So I know that I can exist without my body. It's cool because it makes me not scared of death at all, of dying. It's like, fuck. It's like changing clothes.
Thank you, little plant, and a little harvest.
Hey, hey, gentle. Ah, oh, he's your friend. Be gentle. Come here, hey. Be gentle, okay? Good boy.